So we promise not to hold you up too long before your lunch. We want to share with you some work that we started a little while ago now, when multi-platform was really starting to show signs of significant growth. And at that time, we started to get different questions in research from new people and departments, and they were about audiences and how they were interacting and behaving around content, in what volumes and how often. What were they doing and what were they hoping to find when they got to their platform destination? And so what we want to share with you today is a case study on X Factor, which is just a small part of a much bigger research strategy that is ongoing. So just a bit of background before we get into the research. I moved into broadcast from print just over 4 years ago now, at a time when the doommongers and soothsayers were predicting the death of TV. As PVRs were going to replace the linear schedule, audiences would fragment uncontrollably, and on-demand was going to rule the world. Well, I'm very glad to say that time has proved otherwise, and it's safe to say that those beliefs are quite firmly turned on their head. Well, we hope they are anyway. TV audiences are growing, and technology is providing them with new and innovative ways to make accessing their favourite programmes more enjoyable, convenient and fun. And some of the programmes here have had their biggest audiences ever recently and are defying all expectations. So the key driver to all of this is, of course, premium content that people want to see. Over the last 3 years, there's been an explosion of consumer touch points, places that they can interact with you and your brands, and this is regardless of what industry you happen to be working in. And for ITV, this means that our family of platforms and channels has been growing rapidly and evolving. And today we have 4 TV channels, ITV players online, on TV VOD, and on games consoles, and mobile and red button services. And what we've seen, and again, this is regardless of what industry you're in, is a move from one-channel communications with customers, driven by transactions, to multi-dimensional, multi-platform communications, driven by the consumer desire and will to engage and have a conversation with you. So all this raises new challenges and questions. In a world where ITV makes its revenue from the number of eyeballs it gets, measurement becomes the holy grail. In a world where the consumer is quite literally in control, we also need to learn how to provide content to them in the way and the place that they want it. Our programmes not only need to live and breathe in a multi-platform environment, which is a very different way of thinking for this traditional giant of a broadcaster, but we actually also need to be able to make money from it at the same time. We're slowly unpicking this world, starting from the basis that directing viewer journeys between platforms is more complex than ever. They used to start with a linear view on ITV1 and then feed out or into a handful of other media channels. But now they look like this, a mass of places to go, places to start, places to end, and an infinite number of journeys that you can have taken in between. So this is really from the point from which we started our research. And from hand over to Suzanne.
It's interesting that we started this morning talking about Britain's Got Talent, because actually that's where this particular research project kicked off, and rewind to May 2009 and that Susan Boyle phenomenon. I think probably more vividly than any other media thing in our lives, certainly, that demonstrated how difficult it is for content owners to control and anticipate and monetize that content once it's out there in the new media age. Now, I think one of the big challenges for media owners is that ultimately consumers have a finite amount of time in the day, we all do, and I think we'd be fooling ourselves if we could think we could expand that media time. So we're ultimately really just trying to get a much bigger share of the time that's out there being consumed in media, but to do so profitably. So ITV's challenge is really to find ways to do that by getting people to consume more of our content on as many platforms as possible. So lots of the questions that were being thrown up around about the time that we kicked all this off is which consumers, which media, what content, and how should we be investing? Because I think one of the knee-jerk reactions with all this explosion of opportunities is you just start doing more stuff, but you don't really know what's important anymore.